Hello, this is Jacob Wilson. I'm here today to do a cube draft. I'm biding my time until Battle for Zendikar comes out online. Tomorrow's the paper pre-release for me, but I won't be able to play online for about 9 days. I've never really drafted cube. I never played cube mocks or anything, so I haven't ever really thought about drafting cube perfectly or optimally. I just tend to have a affinity towards blue decks and fast mana. There are so many playable cards, you're rarely gonna be short on playables, so I tend to just pick lands highly. So I'm gonna take Misty. It's the best land in this pack. The next best card is Lightning Bolt. Just Lightning Bolt, Swords to Plowshares, Path, those cards are really good. In this pack, I could take Bayou or Temple Garden. They both work with my Misty, so they have added value. And then past that, there's Fintorn Elves. This card, you might not know what it is. It's a. I don't know what it's from. It might be Plane Chase, Commander, probably Commander. Yeah, that makes more sense. Basically, you get X1 ones with haste. If your opponent wants to have that many, you get double. I think if Fintorn Elves was like Birds of Paradise or Noble Hierarch, I would take it, but Fintorn's not that good. So I'll just take Bayou. Slightly better than Temple Garden because of you don't take any damage. Alright, in this pack. I mentioned that I like mana fixing, fast mana. And right after that, I like planeswalkers. Just if you can get a lot of them, they're great. So in this pack, the best card is Volcanic Island, followed by Garruk. Thran Dynamo is also decent. Garruk is pretty good. If it were like, I would definitely take Chase the Mind Sculptor, and it's probably the only one that I would take. I'm gonna take Volcanic. It works with my Misty, so it's like I have two. It's just really good to start out like this. I'm so open to anything great that I get past. Wood Elves can get Bayou, so that's good. Past that, there's Ralzerik. Venser is really bad, but Ralzerik is fine. It's not a great planeswalker, but I'll take it. I do like to flip some coins if we get to the ultimate. Never even seen this card before. It's a 1/1, and you can make land war elves if you discard a card. I'm just going to take Watery Grave. I'm taking a lot of lands right now, but as we get into pack 2 and 3, then I can shift my focus into taking spells. And if I ever see a great card, I can take it over fixing. Alright, there's Oren Viper and Shadow Mage, pretty similar cards. Chain Lightning, Maelstrom Pulse. Those are the best cards. It's not really clear what colors I am. I'm not really committed to anything. There's a pretty big difference between blue decks without green and green decks. One of them you have fast mana, one of them you don't. I'm just gonna take Maelstrom Pulse. I feel like I can get something like Shadow Mage or Oren Viper later. There are a lot of 3 and 4 mana cards that give you card advantage. So I'll just take Maelstrom Pulse. Bone Treader is the card I would take if I were taking a spell. But I'll just take Drowned Catacomb. Augur is really good. Liliana is so bad. I don't want that. I do want Planeswalkers, but I want them to be good. Prophetic Bolt is also really good, but I'm gonna have a preference for cheaper cards early. All right, I like these cards. I'm either gonna take Huntmaster or Deep Analysis. They're pretty similar. Huntmaster is kind of like a Planeswalker. It's just slightly more fragile. I'll take Huntmaster. Card draw is really plentiful, and you don't want to get too much. I'll happily have one or two, though. Alright, well, this pack is awful. Now I can take Manowar, Grimlovomancer, Trigon Predator. Manowar is really good against aggro. So is Grimlovaman. I don't actually have that many fetch lands. I only have one fetch land and then four duels. So Lovaman's not going to be that easy. Take Burst Lightning or Gargadon. Let's take Burst Lightning. I don't think that this card is playable. Take Mizzium Mortars. As you see, even when you get really late in the pack, the cards you get are still pretty good. I got like Burst Lightning and Mortars. And Chain Lightning. Alright, I have lots of. It looks like red is probably open. I got second to last pick Chain Lightning and then Hell Rider. Okay, this pack is interesting. There's Shackles as one of the best cards. Domri is not going to work out in this deck. So I can take Shackles, Olivia, or Fire Ice. Fire Ice is better than Fork Bolt, much more versatile. I noticed how open red was in the last pack, so I think I should take Shackles, and then I'll wheel either Fire Ice or Olivia. I'm gonna be have to be very careful about my lands to make sure I have enough for Shackles, but I'm willing to do that. Okay, there's the best cards in the pack are Tree Speaker, Mull Drifter, and Grave Titan. I could pretty easily play Grave Titan, but I'm not really about that. I'll just take Mull Drifter. Ooh, Jace. I love Jace. I also like Tundra and Thoughtseize. But yeah, Jace is great. In the last Keep draft I did, I just played Merfolk Looter. And Jace is obviously most of the time much better. Okay. I can take Inquisition. Just decent. I think I'm gonna wheel Flame Slash. Could take Ojitai. I don't really like that. Seagate Oracle is fine. If you got a lot of Planeswalkers, Time Warp is good, but I'm not too interested in that. I think I might play a really small amount of black or not at all. So I don't want to take Inquisition, even though that might be the best card. I'm gonna wheel Flame Slash, right? I already have enough cheap removal. So I'll take Seagate Oracle. Ooh, actually, Mystic Snake. I forgot that I was green. Mystic Snake is really good. Tarmogoyf is pretty decent. I'll probably wheel Anger or Firebolt. This is looking like a constructed deck. Just rug, mid-range. I really like Talrand. She's like a planeswalker. Right. I'll take Chase, though. Like the look of this deck. I like Rug a lot. Steam Vents is great. Perfect. I already have Volcanic, so I would have preferred Scalding Tarn to Steam Vents, but I'll still take it. I could have also taken Exarch, but maybe earlier on in the draft I would have taken Exarch, but not now. It's too likely that I won't get the Splinter Twin. There was a Kiki-Jiki and a few picks ago. Okay. Hollowed Fountain is decent, but I'm probably going to take Chandra or Thundermaw. Thundermaw ends the game very, very quickly. I do like that. And it's really obviously good against Lingering Souls. And I think there are just a lot of flyers with one toughness. I'm happy to play Fire Ice. Okay. I have a lot of black lands that I'm not really using, but it's okay. Cultivate is fine. I'm not really gonna play any of these cards. I could board in Flame Wake. I might not play Hellrider either. Don't know if Atarka is really playable. I really like Avalanche Riders, especially if you have ways to blink it or copy it. Nonetheless, I'm just gonna take Flame Slash. All right, I have too much cheap removal. That's for sure. If I took Firebolt, I would just end up cutting one of these cards. So I'll take the big Angry Goblin. I definitely could have just been mono red with Swift Spear, Gouger, Hellrider. There was a Goblin Guide also. The Goblin is good with Mull Drifter, Huntmaster, Mystic Snake, Manowar. Ooh, I like this a lot. Normally, I can't take Bloodbraid because I have counter spells, but I just don't have any. There are a couple cards that are really good to cascade into. Nothing else in the pack really stands out. Den Protector is really good in Standard, but Standard is really slow. It's still playable in Cube, but it's not as excellent as it may seem. See, you could just get Eternal Witness, which is Den Protector, but it costs 3 mana instead of 5. Thrag Tusk, Control Magic, and Verdant are all really good. See, with Verdant, I could get blue or green. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna take Witness. It's obviously really good to cascade into. But I would happily get Visions, Thrag Tusk, or Verdant later. Control Magic's also fine. All right, I like what I see here. Edric is really good in most decks, but I don't have that many creatures. You want creatures that cost one or two. Then there's Click, Reavesoul, and Ooze. I really like counter spells in general. It is hurt a lot by my Bloodbraid Elf. So I can take Click or Ooze. I don't think anyone is playing mono red, but Ooze is still good. I'll take Click. I'm more scared of combo decks or control deck. Ooh, Shardless Agent. I'm gonna start off a Cascade Chain. Bloodbraid, Shardless. I love this deck. Alright, at this point I have 22 playables. There's a Splinter Twin, I would have got it. And there's a Pestermite in this pack. Wow. This pack has some really good cards. I could take Ancient Tome, which is really good with Jace or Bloodbraid or Huntmaster. Just play them early. It's also just a really bad card, though, if I'm trying to play a long game. There's also Xenagos and Brainstorm. Xenagos is decent, but I already have too much beef, I think. I have only one fetch land, but hopefully I'll get another. I'm off Pestermite and Splinter Twin. I don't really have that much fixing because I took all these black fixing lands. I guess I'll take Shivan Reef. It's really bad, but I guess I'll play it. I can't play Daze. Even Daze is one of my favorite cards. I like all four spikes, and Daze is particularly good. I could sideboard into Garruk. I certainly have the lands. I already have a stupid 7 drop that I don't want to play. Take Chandra, Sphinx. Venusaur is decent. It's very good. It's like Mystic Snake. Roast is also decent. I already have Mortars and Flame Slash. All these cards are fine. Don't really like any of them. Take Duplicate. Verdant. What does that give me? If I play Watery Grave, then it becomes a green blue land. That involves some damage. I'm not above it. My mana might be too bad to play the Angry Goblin. Verdant's also good with Brainstorm. I'll definitely play it. Scepter is fine, but there's already a lot of good destruction, artifact destruction that people main deck. I like the look of this deck. Ace of Charm is a really good counter spell because I can play it, and it's not that bad to cascade into. I think I'll take Ancient Tome and sideboard it in if I see fit. This card is kind of like Shadow Mage. My mana's really bad. Okay, I don't really have enough spells for Augur of Bolas. I can definitely afford to cut one of these cheap removal spells. Chain Lightning or Burst Lightning. Probably Chain. It's sorcery. And then I could cut Cultivate. Or shackles. And I could also cut the angry goblin. I think cultivate is slightly too bad. I have a looter and brainstorm. So I think I want to play 18 lands. So I need to cut two more cards. Cut chain lightning. I can definitely board that in. I'm not going to play ancient tome, but if my opponent's not playing a creature deck, it'll be really good. Could also board into Chandra's Phoenix and Hellrider. Also on the other side of that spectrum, I have Garrick and Atarka to board into. My mana is really atrocious. I would like Sylvan Caryatid or something. The Witness is the only double green card, but I still want to play it. It's too good. So I just won't play that many green sources in my deck. I'll cut Prophetic Flame Speaker. Alright. Okay, this way I'm gonna have 9 blue, 9 red, and 6 green. Alright, I'll be back for the matches.